Chapter 10, called Divine Glory. Sri Krishna speaks. Once more, warrior, hear this highest word of my wisdom. Wishing your welfare, to you I teach it, since your heart delights in the telling. How shall the mighty seers or the devas know my beginning? I am the origin, I the sustainer of seers and devas. Who knows me birthless, never beginning, Lord of the worlds. He alone among mortals is stainless of sin, unvexed by delusion. All that makes man in his many natures, knowledge and power of understanding unclouded by error, truth, forbearance, calm of spirit, control of senses, happiness, sorrow, birth and destruction. What fears? What is fearless? What harms no creature? The mind unshaken, the heart contented, the will austere, the hand of the giver, fame and honor, and infamy also. It is by me only that these are allotted. Forth from my thought came the seven sages, the ancient four, and at last the Manus. Thus I gave birth to the first begetters of all earth's children. Who truly knows me in manifold being, everywhere present and all prevailing, dwells in my yoga, that shall not be shaken, of this be certain. I am where all things began, the issuing forth of the creatures, known to the wise in their love, when they worship with hearts overflowing. Mind and sense are absorbed. I alone am the theme of their discourse. Thus delighting each other, they live in bliss and contentment. Always aware of their Lord are they, and ever devoted. Therefore, the strength of their thought is illumined and guided toward me. There, in the ignorant heart where I dwell, by the grace of my mercy, I am knowledge, that brilliant lamp dispelling its darkness. Then Arjuna speaks. You are Brahman, the highest abode, the utterly holy. All the sages proclaim you eternal, Lord of the Devas. Saintly Narada knew you, the birthless, the everywhere present. Devala echoed your praise, Asitatu and Vyas. Now I also have heard, for to me your own lips have confirmed it. Krishna, this is the truth that you tell. My heart bids me believe you. God of gods, Lord of the world, life's source, O King of all creatures, how shall Deva or Titan know all the extent of your glory? You alone know what you are by the light of your innermost nature. Therefore teach me now and hold back no word in the telling. All the sum of your shapes by which the three worlds are pervaded. Tell me how you will make yourself known to my meditation. Show me beneath what form and disguise I must learn to behold you. Number them all, your heavenly powers, your manifestations. Speak, for each word is immortal nectar. I never grow weary. Then Sri Krishna speaks, saying, O Arjuna, I will indeed make known to you my divine manifestations, but I shall name the chief of these only, for of the lesser variations, in all their detail, there is no end. I am the Atman that dwells in the heart of every mortal creature. I am the beginning, the lifespan, and the end of all. I am Vishnu. I am the radiant sun among the light givers. I am Marichi, the wind god. Among the stars of night, I am the moon. I am the Sama Veda. I am Indra, king of heaven. Of sense organs, I am the mind. I am consciousness in the living. I am Shiva. I am the lord of all riches. I am the spirit of fire. I am Meru among the mountain peaks. Know me as Brihaspati, leader of the high priests, and as Skanda, the warrior chief. I am the ocean among the waters. I am Bhrigu, the great seer. Among words, I am the sacred syllable, Om. I am the vow of Japa. I am Himalaya among the things that cannot be moved. I am the holy fig tree. I am Narada, the godly sage, Chitrarada, the celestial musician, and Kapila among the perfected souls. Among horses, you may know me as Uchchaisrava, who was brought forth from the sea of nectar. I am Airavata among royal elephants. I am king among men. Of weapons, I am God's thunderbolt. I am Kamadanu, the heavenly cow. I am the love god, begetter of children. I am Vasuki, god of snakes. I am Ananta, the holy serpent. Of water beings, I am Varuna. Aryaman among the fathers. I am death, who distributes the fruit of all action. I am Prahlad, the giant. Among those who measure, I am time. I am the lion among beasts, Vishnu's eagle among the birds. Among purifiers, I am the wind. I am Rama among the warriors, the shark among fish, Ganges among the rivers. I am the beginning, the middle, and the end in creation. I am the knowledge of things spiritual. I am the logic of those who debate. In the alphabet, I am A. Among compounds, the copulative. I am time without end. I am the sustainer. My face is everywhere. I am death that snatches all. I also am the source of all that shall be born. I am glory, prosperity, beautiful speech, memory, intelligence, steadfastness, and forgiveness. I am the great Sama of the Vedic hymns and the Gayatri among poetic meters. Of the months, I am Margashishta. Of seasons, the time of flowers. I am the dice play of the cunning. I am the strength of the strong. I am triumph and perseverance. I am the purity of the good. I'm Krishna among the Rishnis, Arjuna among the Pandavas, Vyasa among the sages, Ushanas among the illumined poets. I am the scepter and the mastery of those who rule, the policy of those who seek to conquer. I am the silence of things secret. I am the knowledge of the knower. O Arjuna, I am the divine seed of all lives. In this world, nothing animate or inanimate exists without me. There is no limit to my divine manifestations, nor can they be numbered, O fool consumer. What I have described to you are only a few of my countless forms. Whatever in this world is powerful, beautiful, or glorious, that you may know to have come forth from a fraction of my power and glory. But what need have you, Arjuna, to know this huge variety? Know only that I exist, and that one atom of myself sustains the universe.